Here are the top 10 mistakes made by buyers in pre-construction projects. I am presenting them in no specific order of importance because they are all very important. Not looking at the actual location and surroundings. Do you know what is right now next to the proposed location that might be blocking views or giving you no privacy? Not inquiring about what might be built nearby. Do you know what might be coming down the road that might kill that beautiful view, your privacy, or cause a wind tunnel effect that will prevent you from enjoying the balcony? Are there some older buildings or vacant lots around? You can bet those will be eventually developed. Not looking closely at floor plans, columns, room dimensions, balcony dimensions, etc. This is a big one. Many buyers do not pay close attention to floor plans and then are disappointed when the unit is delivered to find out how small the bedrooms are. A 10-foot by 12-foot room might look big on plans, but in reality, it is a small room. Many buyers have been disappointed to find out there is a big concrete column right in the middle of the living area because they did not pay close attention to the floor plan. Not paying attention to parking spaces and numbers. Do you plan on parking a Rolls-Royce or a large SUV? You better pay attention where your assigned parking spot will be because oftentimes developers make them really small so they have more spaces. If you try to park your large vehicle there, you might have a wall, a column, or another car so close to you that you cannot open your door to get out. Not reading the contract and condo documents and having them reviewed by an attorney. This is a big one. It is important you have the contract reviewed by an attorney who will explain to you what you are legally being bound to, what will happen to your deposit if you want to cancel, and what you can do if the developer does not deliver what you thought you were getting. Not reading the condo docs to understand your rights and restrictions as an owner is another big mistake that can diminish your enjoyment of your future unit. Read them and ask an attorney to explain what you do not understand. Not asking if the developer will retain ownership of common areas or amenities and charge a fee to owners to use amenities. Although not common anymore, there are still some smart developers who are keeping the ownership of the common areas and amenities so they can charge the owners of the condominiums a monthly or annual fee forever. This is a clever way to get future income for them and their descendants. If you are buying in one such project, understand that your condo fees will be higher because of this extra rental fee added to the cost of maintaining these areas. Not understanding the truth about quoted condo fees. This is another big one. The vast majority of developers are quoting estimated condo fees that can be half of what they will eventually be. You see, developers can get cheap construction insurance and do not have to provide all the services and maintenance for very long. But once you close on your unit and the owner's association takes over the management of the building, the insurance goes way up, the maintenance expenses are higher, and also the association has to build reserve funds to be prepared for future major repairs and improvements. Not understanding what a branded condo is. Are you buying in a condominium that is named after a famous designer or celebrity brand? You need to understand that the brand name is licensed to the developer for a fee and that under specific conditions, that brand can be taken away, leaving you with a building that will be called something else, which might cause the value of your unit to go down. buying without proper analysis of the market regarding pricing, cycle, and the positioning of the building. Many buyers are attracted by the sexy million-dollar advertising campaigns designed by the powerful marketing and PR agencies hired by developers. Sometimes rumors or factual information about celebrities, business tycoons, and public figures buying into the project are used to create a buzz and buying frenzy. Do you know where the market is now and where it will be heading when your unit will be delivered? Do you have some historical data that shows you what happened in the last real estate cycle? Do you have any idea where prices might be heading? If you are buying to flip, do you know what will happen when many other buyers like yourself will be putting their units on the market? What makes your building so special that you expect to make a profit? Dealing directly with a developer. Let's face it, most buying decisions are based on emotions, but we try to justify them with logic. Developers know that, and this is why all their marketing and interactions with buyers have one objective in mind: cause the emotional reaction and feelings that will compel you to buy. So are you going to deal with a developer directly, or will you hire an honest and professional agent who will advise you and balance your emotions by injecting some logic and facts into your decision?